All right, George W. Brister, I've got a topic here that's been rolling around in my head for probably 2 weeks. I was a little bit sick for a while, and I decided to take a little time off. And we put up some of the older videos where I could be still, be quiet, think a little bit about the future, what I want to do. It's a long story how I even got into making these videos. I had no plans to do it. I kind of stumbled into it. I believe it was Providence. Providence gets blamed for a lot of stuff, but I believe that's what happened, okay? Long story, and here we are. We're making videos. Been doing them on my own now for, I don't know, 10, 11 months. And I kind of decided I would give it a year and see what the response was, okay? It's been growing, and that's thanks to you and I guess Providence, I'm not sure. But I'm not here selling welding gear. I'm not here selling welding trinkets, and there's nothing wrong with that. I'm not selling whatever. I'm selling me. I guess, just like when I was on the job, I'm selling Gerald Brister and whoever I am. I think the reason God has picked me is because I have a lot of spiritual gifts, and I have a life of experiences. I thought about it when we started doing this, like, why am I doing this? And it's really the sum total of all of my adult life, being here, being there, doing, seeing things, and some things I can't even talk about. That's who makes you who you are. So I can't be any different than I am. I'm not trying to imitate anybody else. I'm not trying to copy anybody else, and not in competition with anybody else. I'm just me. But the audience that I would appeal to, if I'm right, is going to be what I call 10 percenters. In the Revolutionary War, there are some people that say only 10% of the colonists really participated in the war. Most people just wanted peace. Some people call them 3%ers, different things. But there's in mathematics and in history, 10% of people in a church give, 10% of people in an organization really do the work. The thing about 10%, and I'm seeing when you guys come on, you want to be a friend, you want to be this, I look through your life, and it's like I get to look in your life, and I see a lot of 10%ers. What's a 10%er? You believe in God, you believe in country, you may not be perfect, but you would like to do things right, okay? And so when I make my videos, it's like the Forrest Gump thing. Life's like a box of chocolates. You don't know what you're going to get. I don't know what I'm going to get. So you can't possibly know what you're going to get. I have a row of things. And I have a list of topics. People tell me topics. But I never know what I'm going to put out to that day. And believe it or not, it's kind of a spiritual struggle. I understand what's going on here. What does that mean to me? That means to me that somebody that I'm talking to, whether I reach 1 million people, or I reach 100 people, there's somebody out there. You are what's called a divine appointment. That's if I'm where I'm supposed to be and I'm doing what I'm supposed to do, God gets a message to you. So I could be talking about Christianity one day. I have the gifts to be a preacher, but my life was too dirty. I've always thought that welding was my consolation prize. I have people call me the preacher, the welding preacher, Mr. Clean, and some other things that I can't even say here, probably, okay? But you get the point. So I could be talking about welding. I could be talking about life lessons. I'm commanded to help younger people, women, or older men, older women. And I'll be doing that. I'll be showing welding things. And I'll be talking about Bible things, Bible in the news. We see all these events going on. What does the Bible say? And so it's going to be a mix of things. And it's going to be like reality TV. If you want to follow me, I'd be happy to have you on board. If not, I understand. Join the journey. I'm Gerald W. Brister. Thank you.